analogy now is to look on land and see all the things that we can see and the progress that we've gone from maps or something or on bits of paper, and now we all have one on our device we carry around in our pocket. But when you look at the blue pieces of that outside the land, there's nothing there. And our role in mapping is to kind of drain the oceans and make, you know, reveal what's there for people.
The multi-beam is our way to look at the topography of the seafloor, which means we can figure out what parts are higher and lower and if there are interesting features like seamounts or troughs or canyons.
Original expeditions, they would just go out with this piano wire and lead weight and make as many measurements as they could in the time that they had, which is very few. You'd have, you know, maybe 500 soundings in a month-long expedition. Now, with one ping, with one sound pulse that the sonar emits, we get 864 soundings. So we're, you know, vastly able to get higher resolution maps and gathering so much more data, and it's allowing us to understand the Earth like we never have before.
It's extremely useful. Without that, we'd be diving blind on the seafloor.
Be sitting here and mapping and thinking, wow, you know, we're in 4,000 meters of water and we've got a swath width of 8 kilometers and there's seamounts popping out all the time. They're huge mountains that people just don't see normally, and that's fantastic.
You never know what it'll be just beyond that next hill that you're going over.
Less than about 15% of our seafloor has been mapped with a sonar, which means the rest of the ocean that everyone sees in Google Earth has been mapped by satellites, and their resolution is about 1,000 meters on a side, so very coarse resolution. You lose all of the detail that you need to plan actual dives for an ROV.
Someone on board just needs to import the multi-beam data into another program called FlaterMouse, and that allows us to have a 3D visualization of the seafloor. Higher areas are colors like red, and darker areas are colors like blue, and so we get a little painted map of that on our computer screen as we go along. That way we can go around, manipulate it, and find those particular mounds or troughs that look promising.
We have a very robust operation. There's bulky data to be moved around. There's certain parameters with which we want to be on the same page while we're processing that data, creating products. Then later, we want to make sure that we're being consistent in what we're outputting, and eventually with the idea that those go into public repositories. So the importance there is organization, and you can't really reach organization of that level without communicating with your team members.
Teamwork is of the utmost importance. We're living in very tight quarters. Logical thinking, communication is essential. Composure under stress are probably the biggest things.
Right now, a lot of the communities that benefit from our mapping are primarily scientific. However, as we move towards entering this data into public repositories, eventually they're incorporated on products that we use every day.
But without the maps, without even the preliminary maps, we wouldn't have even known there's something strange to look at there, something that wasn't explained by our current scientific knowledge.
Without it, we really wouldn't be here. The more we can communicate that with people, the better.
But it also is great for that next generation, you hope, that will follow on and in the footsteps and do better than us.